Welcome to SMS classes. In this video, I'm going to explain bubble sort algorithm and how to implement as a Java program. What is sorting? Arranging elements in an order. If you consider this as your unordered list, ascending order means arranging them from small to big order. In case of strings, it is alphabetical. Descending order means arranging them from big to small order. Okay. Let's get started with bubble sort algorithm in ascending order. Imagine if you have to sort only two elements, 4 being the first element and 5 being the second element. Here, 4 is already less than 5, so you no need to do anything as they are already in ascending order. But if 5 as your first element and 4 as your second element, 5 is greater than 4, so we must swap. What a swap means, 4 should go to the first position and 5 should come to the second position. Though this step looks very simple, but this is your key process of your bubble sort algorithm. Now, imagine you have 5 elements in your array like this. As bubble sort says, we have to compare the first two elements. Here, 5 is greater than 4, so we have to swap them. So at the end of this step, our array looks like 4, 5, 3, 2, 1. Again, we have to continue this process for the next two elements. So this time we are going to compare 5 and 3. Again, 5 is greater than 3, we must swap. So at the end of this step, your array will look like 4, 3, 5, 2, 1. Again, we have to compare the next two elements, this time 5 and 2. Again, 5 is greater than 2, we must swap. So the array elements looks like 4, 3, 2, 5, 1. Now we have to compare the last two elements. Again, 5 is greater than 1, we must swap. So at the end of the fourth step, the array elements looks like 4, 3, 2, 1, 5. Now, did we sort it? Not fully, but one element. Let's have a quick recap on what we did so far so that you will understand better. So we compared the first two elements and we swapped them. Then we compared the next two elements, we swapped them. Next, we compared the next two elements, we swapped them. Then the last two, we swapped. As you see here, the 5 is slowly moving to the last, which means the biggest number moved to the last. And in case of index comparisons, we compared 0, 1, then we compared 1 and 2, we compared 2 and 3, and we compared 3 and 4. So totally 4 iterations. This is what your typical inner for loop of your program. While doing program, you will understand this more better. Now, we sorted one number. Now we need to repeat this process to sort all the elements of the array. Now, again, we start from the beginning. We compare the first two elements. Again, 4 is greater than 3. We're going to swap. Now we are comparing 4 and 2. Again, 4 is greater than 2. We are swapping. Now 4 and 1. Again, 4 is greater than 1. We are swapping. Now if you see, 4 and 5, we are not going to compare because 5 is already sorted. So index comparisons, if you see, we have compared 0 and 1, we compared 1 and 2, we compared 2 and 3. Now only 3 iterations we went. So as compared to the previous step, it was 4 iterations, now only 3. This is an important concept to understand. Now next time, again it's starting from the beginning. Again it's comparing the first two elements, it'll swap. Then it'll compare the next two, it'll swap. As you see already, I highlighted in gray, the 4 and 5 are already sorted. So 3, 4, 4, 5 are not going to get compared. So which means this time 0, 1, 1, 2, only 2 times we are going to compare. Now next time if you see, we're going to compare the first two elements. Again, it is big, small, swap it. So the elements will look like this. This time we compared only once, that is 0 and 1. Now, have you noticed the array is already sorted? That is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. That is bubble sort algorithm. Now, let's see how to implement this as a Java program. Now, we need to compare the first two elements, that is A of 0 and A of 1. How will you write this as a Java program? If A of 0 greater than A of 1. Now, we want to explain one of our special way of writing programs. Typically, you would have seen for loop. Suppose if you would have seen the bubble sort already, a for loop is what the first line of your bubble sort will be. But if you see the way how we are writing program, we are starting from, let's say, a if. Now, what is the difference we are making here? It's not that remembering a program, memorizing and writing it from the first line. Now, you understand the logic and you implement it step by step, as the algorithm says. So the algorithm says, compare the first two elements. So I'm checking if A of 0 is greater than A of 1. So we don't know whether it needs two for loops and all that at this point in time. So always have a habit of doing program step by step. So we are comparing 5 with 4 using this Java line. Now we need to swap. Now swapping means what? One value should go to A of 0. A of 0 value should go to A of 1. But some students may do a mistake here the very first time, right? Now A of 1 you store in A of 0, that is 4 will go to the first position. But in this process, when 4 goes to first place, the 5 will be erased. That is, there is no more 5 in the array now. Now when you store A of 0 in A of 1, the same 4 gets copied into the second position. So both the array elements will have only 4. So we did a wrong swapping. So I'll quickly explain what is swapping. Imagine you have a cup of coffee and you have a cup of tea and you need to swap it, meaning the tea cup should have coffee and coffee cup should have tea. How will you do this? You need an empty cup. So similarly, to do in our program also, so we are comparing A of 0 is greater than A of 1. To do swapping, take a temporary variable. That is, store A of 0 in temporary variable. So 5 gets copied into the temp. Now you can store A of 1 in A of 0. That is, now 4 gets copied into A of 0. Now you can put back 5 from temp to A of 1. So we finish swapping now. So this is the right way of doing it. Now we need to continue this process. So we compared 0 and 1. Next, we have to compare 1 and 2. Next, we need to compare 2 and 3. Next, we need to compare 3 and 4. Now, as you can see here, this process repeats for 4 more times. So the index is moving from 0, 1, 2, and 3. So I write a for loop to achieve this, 0 to 3. So I can substitute this as I. And the other side, if you see, it is 1, 2, 3, 4. So which is I plus 1. That is, when I is 0, I need a 1. When I is 1, I need a 2. When I is 2, I need a 3. So I plus 1. So we substitute wherever 0 is there to a I and wherever 1 is there to a I plus 1. Like we already discussed, this process will sort only one element. That is, 5 will get sorted. Now, this whole process we need to repeat to sort all the elements of the array. So it repeats for 4 more times. So we need an outer for loop to repeat this as 4 times. So I write a Z loop from 0 to 3. This itself will sort the elements, but the inner loop all the time goes 4 times. But if you see the index comparisons which we had before, it was reducing every time. That is, first 4 times, then 3 times, then 2 times, then 1 time. So when Z is 0, 1, 2, and 3, using this, how to reduce the number of times of your inner for loop. So a small mathematics will help you here. 3 minus Z, that is, 3 minus 0 will give 3. 3 minus 1 will give you 2. 3 minus 2 will give you 1. 3 minus 3 will give you 0. So I replace my inner for loop to 3 minus Z. Now I'll show you this in BlueJ, how the program works. Now, so what is the first step? If A of 0 is greater than A of 1, we need to swap. So I take a temporary variable, store A of 0, then in A of 0, I copy A of 1. Now in A of 1, I put temporary. So swapping done. Now we compare these two. Next we are going to compare the next two. So if you see, the index was moving. So I need a loop to repeat this. So int I is equal to 0, I less than or equal to 3, and I plus plus. So I replace all my zeros with I and 1 with I plus 1. Yes, in this process, our 5 gets sorted. Now we need to repeat this to sort all the elements. So we need out of our loop. Like I said before, this has to reduce to 3, 2, 1, and 0 each time. So we are writing 3 minus that here. That's it. Bubble sort algorithm we implemented. Now, for you to see it working, I'll just print the array. So I'll just run this program. So you can see in ascending order, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, if you have to do descending order, imagine your elements are like this. Descending order means big to small. The algorithm remains same. The only difference will be in ascending order, if first was big, second was small, you are swapping. Now, in descending order, if first is small, second is big, we need to swap because we want bigger number to be in the beginning. So we just change this to a less than sign and that's it. We're done. Now, if you see the program output, we will get 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, which is descending order. Now, one more scenario. If you don't know the size of the array, now I have fixedly written for 5 elements. So you can see hard-coded 4, 3, etc. If you don't know the array element or if you have to do for n elements, then you can substitute here as a dot length minus 1. You know a dot length will give 5. We need a 4 here. Now, in this case, it is 3. I hope you all know equal to 3 is nothing but less than 4. Right, either way you can write, great, less than or equal to 3 is nothing but less than 4. So a dot minus 2, actually, because it is 5 minus 2, 3. Typically answer will be like less than and minus 1 here. And here also a dot length minus 1. That's it. This will work for any given size of the array. Now, one more variant in this I want to talk about is string array. Imagine if you want to do sorting for a string array and assume the elements are like this, like EEE and DDD, CCC, BBB, and AAA. Now, the algorithm remains same. What is the first difference? That is, you can't use greater than less than signs for string. Here I'm assuming you know strings and comparative method in that because this intention is only bubble sort. In later videos, we'll upload strings and their methods. So we should use comparative method. So we are basically checking if the first element is greater than the second. That is, if the first element is greater than the second. So comparative will give a positive number in this case. So if this is greater than 0, we should swap. Then the next difference is, obviously, our temporary variable should not be integer, it should be string. That's it, we're done. Now, if you see, we implemented bubble sort for a string array as well. So, you can see in ascending order, AA, BB, CC, DD, and EEE. Thank you for watching. Hope this was useful and you understood how to implement a bubble sort algorithm in Java. We'll see you in the next video.